All right, guys. Danny Boy here from Manila's Wave 89.1 Mix Global on Kumu and Twitch. I'm here with the only, one and only Nadine Lustre. Thank you so much.
Hey, what's up, Danny?
I'm doing good. And you know what? I want to thank you for your time. I know you're like, you're promoting your new single right now, Wildest Dreams, and you're everywhere.
So thanks for having me. Thanks for having me.
Of course. You know, we just playlisted your song, so we're going to get into that in a bit. But I kind of wanted to talk about, like, let's talk about 2018 when you started with Careless and you had your first single, Stay Up. So from that time, that era with Stay Up to now, you know, what's changed in terms of your musical influences and like the way you write and approach making music now compared to 2 years ago?
Yeah, actually, Stay Up, I didn't write that.
Okay.
Back then, I couldn't really write. Writing has always been an insecurity of mine, like ever since I was younger. I think around 16 years old, I tried writing. I wasn't really, you know, super successful with it. So I kind of closed that book and decided not to, you know, just leave it at the shelf and not to touch it again. Because I really got insecure with it. And so fast forward to, I guess, 2018, which is the Careless mixtape. I have two songs in there. And one of the songs I wrote, it's called I Like It. So I'm the one who wrote it. That's my first song that I've ever written ever.
Wow.
So yeah, but then before it, like, songwriting isn't really my thing, you know. But I guess because of the pressure of having, you know, everyone in the crew being able to write, and you know, and they're very creative. I just had to step up my game and, you know, and try writing again, and right. I was successful with it.
Yes. You know, that, yeah. I was talking to Messiah and I talked to Brett a little bit not too long ago. And I was saying to them that that Careless mixtape from 2018 is a classic, in my opinion.
Like, yeah.
It's amazing. Like, all you guys killed it. How fun was it working on that? How was it, like, the memories you have on just creating that project together? Like, what was the fondest memory you have from that era in your music?
Well, definitely it would be when the mixtape was launched on Spotify. When it came out, we were all just at James's house, and we were all just, you know, like, hyped up and waiting for the songs to be released. As soon as it premiered, like, we were all just there celebrating, we were drinking. Like, it just felt really good to know that, you know, that I put out, or there's a song that's out there that I've written, you know, just, well, because I was successful with the fear of writing, so. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I got over it. So yeah, it was just a good experience all in all.
For sure. And you know, like, even just last year, you guys had that Island City playlist. And
yeah,
I remember you were on that track. I think it was called Headspace with the...
Yes.
Was it Curtis, Messiah, and Billy Davis? Am I right?
Billy Davis, yes.
Right.
That's right.
And you know, one thing that I noticed, and many others, of course, noticed, that your chemistry, no matter who's featured, like with Careless, who's on the track, you guys have great chemistry. So, you know, easy thing to get right away, or did it take time to develop? Because it feels like it just, like, out of nowhere, you guys came through with a classic, and then you guys, everything you guys do together is dope. So, like, is it easier than it looks, or what?
I feel like it's just because we all have the same vibe. We're all very passionate when it comes to music, and, you know, like, we all have that drive. We all want this. So maybe aside from, you know, being good friends, we also have that. So in a way, we're all synced and we jive. Maybe that's the reason why, you know, everything just works effortlessly.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know, when I talk to, like, people that, not only singers and actors, even like athletes, when they say they have this, like, camaraderie with their crew, it always translates into their recordings.
Yeah,
or to
that's correct. That's
their
true.
Games. So that's cool.
True.
Really cool. Really cool. It feels really genuine too. But
yeah.
One more collab I want to talk about in your recent past before we get to the new stuff. Was your collaboration with Ruby Ibarra, amazing
yes.
rapper.
Yes, oh my God.
No 3-2. How did that come together? How did you guys link up?
I actually didn't write No 3-2. It was Brett who wrote it.
Oh.
Because at that time, I was really, like, I was really busy with a lot of, you know, with a lot of things. I was still working on a movie back then. So mm-hmm. Brett just approached me and he was like, yo, I have this song for you. You'll collaborate with this artist, but she's in the States. She's a good rapper, blah, blah, blah. And he wouldn't tell me who it is. but then, because back then, like, I would listen to Ruby Ibarra songs already. So when he told me that I'll be collabing with Ruby, like, I went crazy. I was super excited. And then, like, at the studio, I remember, like, I was so conscious. Like, every time I would sing, I'd ask Brett, like, yo, is that cool? Do you think she's gonna like it? Like, I was just so nervous. But then it turned out great.
Yeah.
It turned out great, yeah.
Definitely. It's been featured here on our station, too. So, dope track. But now, we get to October 2020. You announced that you're going to have your first full-length album under Careless Music.
Yes.
It's called Wildest Dream. So let's get into that. Let me just, before we move on, like the title, just the title track alone. Why Wildest Dreams? Does it mean anything to you?
Yeah. I would always dream, like, every night. So I always have the most vivid dreams. That's why, I don't know, most of the songs in the album are inspired by dreams, actually. And Wildest Dreams is also inspired by one of the most vivid dream that I had. And that dream is just very meaningful. So I thought, you know, why not write a song about it? Should I go into details or
Before we get to that, because I know it's out on the 31st, right? Officially, the whole album. Okay.
Yes.
Before we get there, I want to do some random question time, and then we'll get to the music one more time before I let you go. Okay, cool.
Okay, cool.
This is called randomness, and I do this with everybody. Let's see. Let's have some fun. All right. First thing you do, Nadine, when you wake up?
Check my phone for the time.
What's the last thing you ate?
A salad.
A salad. Okay. And... growing up, you know, as a kid, maybe teenager, who was your celebrity crush?
Oh my God, Orlando Bloom.
Oh, that's a popular answer. Okay.
Yeah.
Where were you the last time you truly got lost? Like literally lost, like you don't know where you are direction wise.
Oh my God. I can't remember. Like nervous, scared, I'm lost. Kind of lost?
No. Like you don't know where to go, like left, right, directions.
Oh, okay, like heads, directions. I can't remember. maybe the other, like last Saturday, but we weren't really lost because we went to Manila, walked around Intramuros, but we weren't really lost. So I can't remember, like lost, I can't remember.
You know, I ask that because nowadays it's so hard to get really lost because there's, you know, ways. And...
there's ways, exactly.
Right. So speaking of that, like, how about traveling? Where is your favorite place to travel to?
Japan.
Whereabouts? Tokyo?
Tokyo, yeah.
Okay. What is your favorite Pinoy dish, Filipino dish?
Oh my God. That's so hard. Kare-kare.
I love that too. Okay. Would you rather see colors that no one else can see or smell things that no one else can smell?
Oh my God. see colors that no one else can see.
Okay. All right. Name three artists, any type of genre, three artists that you'll never get tired of listening to.
Bjork, Coldplay, and Jefferson Airplane.
Oh, nice. Okay. Name a movie that no matter how many times you've seen it, you'll never get tired of it.
Mr. Nobody.
Okay. What's worse in your opinion? Have you ever been in a situation where like you thought someone's waving at you and you wave back, but it's not for you? or you send a very personal detailed text to the wrong person. Which one's worse?
Oh my God. The text message. Because the wave you can get out of that. Like, you know, just pretend that someone else behind that person was waving as well. So you're like, hi, and then you just walk away.
Yeah, and definitely.
That happened to me so many times already.
Oh my God, it happened to me a million times. It's so embarrassing. Okay. All right, two more of these. Would you rather have 10 lives that are 100 years each or one life that's 1,000 years total?
Oh my God. Wait, isn't that... Oh, no. 10 lives, that's 100 years each. So then I could become someone else after 100 years.
There you go. All right. And one question that I wanted to ask was, we have a new show on Mix coming very soon. It's called Filgrimage. So basically what they do is they take eight...
Filgrimage?
Filgrimage, like F-I-L. And they take eight PhilAm student ambassadors to the Philippines for the first time to learn about the culture, right? So my question would be, if you were to take them somewhere to help them learn about the culture or show them something, what would you show them about the Philippines?
I guess I'd take them to Intramuros. Legit though, I was there. I was there last weekend, and like my perspective of the Filipino culture totally changed. And you know, our culture is really something beautiful, and it's something to, you know, it's something that we should be proud of. And like, you know, taking them to Intramuros, it's just, it felt like magic when I was there. Like there was magic in that whole area.
Yes, I love it there. It's a great choice. Definitely. That's probably where I think they might go there too, actually. All right. Well, thank you for answering those. Now let's get back into Wildest Dreams. So what were you aiming for? Let's just talk about the single, because I know the album's coming out in a few days. So maybe you don't want to give too much away.
Yeah.
The single is out. So what's the concept of the single and the visual, like the video? Like, can you give us that much?
Wildest Dreams, the song is actually about a hike. It's a hike that we took back in 2017, I think, in Sagada. So I know my lyrics are very, you know, it's very like, it doesn't make any sense. But to me, like everything that I saw during that hike, it all makes sense to me. So a lot of people get confused, especially with the lines, I'm seeing purple in the sky, I climb so high, the sun is waving. But really, when I said the line, I'm seeing purple in the sky, it's because when we hiked Sagada, I brought a purple mandala with me.
Oh.
So we had an overnight on the mountain, and then the next day we had a boodle fight. And that mandala is the one, there's actually a photo of it. That mandala is the one that's holding the food and the banana leaf. So I'm seeing purple in the sky, and just, you know, I just kind of threw it out there. I climbed so high, obviously, because that the mountain is, it's a very steep hike, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's very steep, it's very high. So that, and then the sun is waving, because the first day that we, when we got there, the first day, because you know, it's a very, like, it's on the top of the mountain. So as the sun was going down, come like 4 p.m. or 5 o'clock, the sun is directly right in front of us. And there's also a photo to, you know, explain that scene, that view. And it's right directly in front of us. And it seems like the sun is waving at us.
Wow.
So that's really the, that's really beautiful. The visual for that.
Wow, that's amazing.
Because a lot of people ask me why are the lyrics like that? Well, you know, I had to show them the photo. It's because it's this and this.
It makes sense. It definitely makes sense now. But you know, I kind of like that approach when artists take that kind of abstract, poetic approach, because sometimes some songs are meant to be listened to like face value, like what you hear is what you get, and those that's okay. But this particular track, you kind of have to like know,
to dig deep and dive into the lyrics.
Cool.
But really, it's very visual.
Okay.
I
like that's it. I like
Thank
it. It's very cool. It's very cool, and you know, it's on the playlist now. It's on Wave 89.1. So everyone watching and listening, do vote for the Daily Top 10 Countdown. And
yes,
also,
please.
It's also on heavy rotation on Mix Radio, on Dash Radio.
Nice. So thank you so much. Thank you.
We're really pushing it. And, you know, whenever a song like this comes around, we got to play it, right? It's dope. But let me ask you a couple things about it. Like, it's been over a year since your last, solo track, if I'm not mistaken. So any reason in particular for the hiatus, I guess you can call it, between songs?
I guess there were just a lot of things that happened, you know, the past, before the whole pandemic happened. There's so many things I was going through,
mm-hmm.
with my career, and of course with the relationship as well, but everything's all Gucci. This is now, you know, a new path that I'm taking. It's a new Nadine emerging from like a phoenix, like from the ashes. So it's something new for me. It's like opening a new door. And, you know, I'm really excited because everyone's definitely going to see a new me this time.
Cool. And any last message you want to send to your fans here in the Philippines and those watching around the world?
Yes, I just want to thank everyone for supporting Wildest Dreams. I know everyone's been looking forward to this. I know everyone's so excited about the album. You know, a lot of the fans have been bugging me since, I think, during the lockdown, because they've been asking for the songs. You know, it's like what you said, it's been a while since I released a song, actually 1 year now, last year. So everyone's been bugging me about the songs, and now it's coming. I hope you all like it, and I hope it inspires you as well.
And the release date for Wildest Dreams, the whole project, is on the 31st.
On the 31st, which is my birthday.
Happy birthday. Happy Thank Halloween.
You. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Best of luck, everyone tuning in. Once again, do support.
Thank you, Danny.
Thank you, and God bless, and best of luck with everything, and we'll be here to support.
Thank you so much.
All right. Thank you. God bless. Peace.
Thank you.